everybody. My name is Matt Elliott, and I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on Highway 99. Today I want to show you a trailer that just came in. It is a brand new 2024 Hideout from Keystone. It's the 34 FKDS, and this thing, it's such a great floor plan inside. You're going to love it. There's a lot to talk about on this coach. And of course, the nice thing is Hideout's a long-term name in the industry. It's been around a long time. They build a really good trailer. It's durable, it's reliable, and we're the dealer here for them here at RV Corral. We've had them for years. They're excellent trailers. Okay, let's take a quick look around some of the bells and whistles on the outside. Okay, one of the first things I want to show you is the battery rack on this. They have gone to an oversized battery rack, so you can have large batteries, you can go to lithium ion batteries, you can, if you're doing some boondocking, this is a trailer that's got ample space for battery power, and that's really nice. Of course, we do have the power tongue jack, and way down there, it's hard to see, but there's a battery disconnect switch. I really like that because that lets me shut down the power to my batteries so I don't have any draws on the system when I'm not using the trailer. That's really good. Okay, now if we come up here, this is something pretty impressive. This is an on-demand hot water heater. Now, a bigger coach like this, you might be staying in it a little bit longer, might be taking some showers. With this one, you could take a longer shower. You don't have to do the, you know, turn on, get wet, turn off, soap up, rinse off. You know, you could just go ahead and take a shower in this one. That's really nice. This has power stabilizer jacks. It's got a barbecue outlet, a propane outlet here, so you can hook up a grill or a barbecue outside and cook out here. And that's really nice. We've got the great big steps. These steps are great because they don't bounce the whole trailer when you walk in and out of them, and they fold away nice and easy. And that also takes away something that hangs down under your trailer, so it improves your ground clearance to get rid of this. Okay, let's walk around back here. This has the solar flex inverted outlets. Now, if that means that if you hook up an inverter to this coach, I can use this outlet and I can run a 110 thing like a TV set outside. And anytime you see these little yellow tabs on these outlets, it means they're inverted outlets. So this is pre-wired for an inverter. And actually, I want to mention, this already has 220 watts of solar on it right now. So you can get continuous charging from solar. And even if you have your batteries disconnected, your solar panels will still top your batteries off. That's a really great feature. Let's walk around here. Now, you see there's two big doors on this coach. So you'll see when we go inside what that does for you. It gives you a lot of room. And then when we walk back here, I want to mention that this has a pre-wire for a backup camera. So if you want a backup camera, it's easy for us to add that. Also, this is set up with a portable ladder system, and you can get a collapsible ladder. So the plus with that is instead of having a ladder that makes your trailer longer and adds about 36 holes to your trailer, because every single part of the ladder, every one of those little posts needs four screws around it. You can imagine how many screws it takes to have a ladder in your trailer. This one doesn't have that. And so now I have a lot less holes, and that's great. This is a fully walkable roof, so if you want to go up and maintain your seals or take off debris or clean things up, you can do that with this one, with one of those portable ladders. Okay, let's walk around here. A little detail I kind of like. This has a removable shore cord. That means that when I, you know, a lot of trailers, you pull the power cord out of a little hole in the side of the trailer. With this one here, I put the cord on when I want it, and I take it away and put it away when I don't want it. And there's no hole here. Well, I call that a mouse hole. And so, you know, if you had Fritos in your trailer and the mouse wants to climb up the little cord and go in your trailer, that hole is how he would do it. Now we don't have a mouse hole. I think that's a pretty good idea. Now you could see here that we have two big slide outs. And another thing that you can tell is that we have very, very good ground clearance under this trailer. So you don't have to worry so much about getting hung up on stuff as you back into a campsite. Another interesting point, you can see two wastewater dumps on this. This has extra gray water storage. Because of the floor plan, the kitchen's in the very front and the bathroom's in the very back, so we have twice as much gray water as we would normally get. That's pretty cool. Okay, that's a look at the exterior. Let's go in and see what it's like inside. All right, so now we're on the interior of the brand new Keystone Hideout 34 FKDS. This is a spectacular living space. There's so much to talk about here. What you can see, first of all, is you have a lot of seating. Now, this is a little sofa bed, and it'll pull out and make an extra bed. Over here, we have theater seats. And here's the thing, the theater seats are right across from your big TV, so you can see very easily. You know, this TV doesn't, you don't have to crane your neck when you're sitting here. We've got a place for my remote controls and stuff, and a little cup holders here as well. And then another thing this has is it has the electric fireplace. Now, if you're parked where you have electricity, you can really, really cut down on your propane use. And this is nice because it's quiet. It's very ambient. It gives you really, really nice heat. So that is a wonderful feature. We also have the media center here. You can use Bluetooth to, you know, connect to your audio system in here, and you can hook in USB and HDMI stuff. You can do all kinds of things with that. Now, if we look over here, we see we have a dinette booth. And this dinette booth is kind of cool because, first of all, we've got easy access into the storage underneath. So I don't have to take everything apart to get to what I have stored in there. And the other thing is this table. Now, this table is a freestanding table, and it's actually got little dog legs here. And it can be this tall, or it can fold down to coffee table height. Now, when I make it coffee table height, I can use it to make an extra bed here with the, you just set it down and then the cushions go across. But the other thing I can do is I can put it right here. So let's say I'm socializing. We got people sitting here. We got people sitting here. Here's the coffee table. There's your nuts and your snacks, and there's the game. So everything is really cool in here socially. Now, the other thing is, it's very hard to find a front kitchen trailer. Well, front kitchens are great for a lot of reasons. One is that when I'm up here being a mad scientist and everybody's down here socializing, I'm not right in the middle. I'm out of the way. I can do what I want. I don't have traffic through my kitchen, but I can still be part of the conversation. Look at all this counter space. We've got so much room to spread out here, and if I have a toaster and a blender and a coffee pot and all that stuff, I've got plenty of room for it. We've got drawers, we've got shelves, storage. There's room for a garbage can. A lot of rigs don't really have room for a garbage can. That's a big deal. Got an oven. So, you know, it's kind of interesting how many trailers today don't really have an oven, but now we can make a pizza or biscuits or whatever. Got a nice three burner stove with a glass top right here. And you could see, remember I was talking about these inverted outlets? So again, we have the capability of doing that on this in the kitchen area. Lots of storage up here. Now here's a big deal. This is the new 12 volt fridge. So if you think about RV fridges, they usually run on propane or 110 electricity, like that shore power. With this one here, I can run this off my batteries. With solar and battery, I've got continuous charging, and these use very little energy. They're extremely efficient. But the best part is I get a lot more room in here without all that propane equipment in the back. I get a much bigger cabinet, so I have more food storage. That's really cool. Now, here's a special surprise feature. Check this out. Wow, pantry space. Now, a lot of times when people have a bigger coach like this, they're staying in it for longer periods of time. They need to store more food, more appliances, more whatever. And this gives you room to do all that. And it's put away so you can stay organized. It's a beautiful design. So for living space, you're just not going to find a trailer with more in it than this. Couple more details. Down here, we have floor ducted heat in this coach, but they've developed a new kind of vent cover that will let the heat out, but it won't let dirt and debris in, so you don't have to worry about dust and dirt going down into your ductwork. That's a big deal. Another thing that's really cool is the air conditioning system distributes through the whole entire coach, and we have these new kind of vents that distribute the air this way instead of just blowing it down you point them where you think you want them. This one cools the whole trailer. It's a lot more efficient and it's a lot nicer. More storage up here. And then we come back here in our private areas. We've got this great bathroom. So, you know, look at this. This has got a shower you can easily step into. It doesn't have a high tub height, so it's easy to get in and out of. And that's really, really adequate. And then we've got nice counter space. Again, we have another inverted switch here for plugging in if we want. And we've got a porcelain toilet with a foot pedal flush. So that's great. And you can see we have air conditioning ducts and heat ducts in here. So it'll be very, very pleasant in here. Okay, let's go back here. And then this is another just really, really great feature. This is the bedroom. Now I mentioned earlier, this has two big slides. This is the bedroom slide. And what they've done here is they've put in a king size bed. This lifts up, of course. There's a whole bunch of storage down there. There's equipment for, I didn't mention earlier, this has an onboard vacuum cleaner. So some that's what's in that bag is the parts to hook up your vacuum cleaner. Nice feature. So you got a really big roomy bedroom. And then here, we've got a huge wardrobe. Again, with travel trailers, there's never enough storage. There's never enough clothing storage, especially if you're somebody that's going to be using your trailer for extended periods. So this has really good clothing. Now, this is a real cool deal too. Another huge storage cabinet that I can use for hanging storage, but it is also set up so that if I want, I can have a washer dryer in here. The power supply is there, the plumbing is there, and we can install a washer dryer in this trailer if you're so inclined. And if you don't need that, boom, more storage. So that is a great bedroom. So that's a quick look at the brand new Keystone Hideout 2024-34 FKDS. This is a magnificent trailer and I really enjoyed showing it to you. I hope that you liked the video, and if there's any questions you have, I'd love to talk to you. You can reach me at the RV Corral. Call me at 541-954-8495. Thanks a bunch. You have a great day.